Okay, I gotta film this video while the sun is still out. Hey guys, so welcome back to my channel. This video is going to be kind of like a random video. I don't think I've ever really done anything like this. I've done portions of videos like this in my vlogs where I just put my camera down on my table and I just talk, but I haven't really done a whole video dedicated to me just sitting here and talking about random stuff. I just don't do this often, and this is something I just want to try and implement on my channel because I really enjoy watching chit-chat type of videos where people just ramble along and talk about different things in their lives or just different things that's going on in the world. I really appreciate that, so I want to just kind of implement that on my channel, and I hope you guys also enjoy it and like these types of videos. I don't know, let me know. But yeah, today I'm just going to be rambling about all the things that have basically kept me sane over the past few weeks. So I'm gonna be talking about like my favorites for the month. I guess this is kind of like a monthly favorites video. Yeah, I'm going to be talking about the things that I've liked in different categories, whether it's gaming, stationery, music, YouTube channels. I'm just gonna sit here and just talk to you guys because I know there's a lot of you guys out there, like even myself, we're all just stuck at home. I mean, those who are like fortunate enough to stay at home during this time, we're just stuck at home. We're looking for things to watch and things to just entertain us while we're stuck in quarantine and stuck in self-isolation. So yeah, I just want to keep you company during this time. But yeah, let's just get straight into it. Oh, by the way, I will leave a description or just details on where I got these items in the description box below, so just check that out first before you ask me where I got these items. So first I'm gonna talk about stationery, because stationery is pretty much like the main thing that I talk about or focus on my channel. I do have a lot of stationery, but I haven't really been buying a lot of stationery, like new stationery, because I don't know, I don't really have the reason to buy new stationery. I have so much stationery, and plus I just haven't really been seeing anything new that I've been wanting to buy. These are the things that I've been using more often within my collection. So first of all, the first stationery item that I've been using a lot these days is my pastel highlighters. I think this is like a dupe for like the Stabilo highlighters that are like pastel, but they just do the job so well whenever you need to highlight something. I've been using these to just highlight and fill out my trackers and maybe do some decorating, because I don't really like highlight anything. I don't have readings to highlight, so they don't really serve that purpose for me, but they still do a really good job in decorating and filling in my trackers and my planner. And I just really like these. I really like the colors, and honestly, I like these better than like the Zebra Mod Liner highlighters that are in the pastel set. I actually have that set, but that set is a bit too fluorescent in my opinion. Like, if I wanted to use a fluorescent highlighter, I guess I'll use that. But of course, everyone really likes the mild and pastelness of some other colors, and they just aren't that harsh to the eyes, so that's why, you know, I like these highlighters. The next stationery item that I've been using these days is my Pilot Juice pens that are in this rainbow color set. When I first got this set of Pilot Juice pens, I was like thinking that I don't like necessarily need it, because at the time I don't really do notes, and I wasn't really sure how I would use this in my everyday life or just in my journal or my planner. But honestly, I get so much use out of this now when I fill out my planner. Especially, I use these pens to outline lettering. I use these pens to just differentiate different like notes that I need to keep track of. It's just been really helpful in so many different ways, and I just love these colors. They just work so well. I don't know, these pens have just been a lifesaver when filling out my planner and just decorating it. These stickers have been so helpful when decorating my planner. I love these little characters that are on it. There's just so many different stickers of her in different situations, and I just love decorating my spreads using these stickers. Because my color scheme for March has been pretty similar to this color scheme, it's been really enjoyable using these stickers. It's just such a nice element to put in your planner if you have no other way of decorating your spreads. Stickers are so good when it comes to decorating. I really want to get more stickers like these. If you know where I can get stickers like these, other than AliExpress, let me know. This is pretty much the last thing that I'm gonna talk about in terms of stationery, because there's not really anything else that I've been using a lot. But either way, this has been a big part of my life ever since I got it. And I think you guys will know as well, this is my 6-ring binder planner. I am religiously using this planner, and I'm just like that. Like, I like to keep in track with all the things I need to do. I don't necessarily decorate it every single day, because sometimes I just don't have the creativity and I just don't feel motivated to decorate it, but I still use it to plan my everyday life. I just use a pencil and write down the notes, and then later on I'll go back and decorate it. It's just been really useful and enjoyable to use. This is pretty much where I explore and just use most of my creativity. It's honestly been so fun and enjoyable, and I just really enjoy the whole 6-ring binder hype. It's really cute, and I really enjoy the process of filling in a 6-ring binder. So yeah, that is my last stationery favorite. Okay, moving on to miscellaneous items, because I don't know what other like category to put this in, but there's only just like 2 things anyway. So one miscellaneous item that I've been using like religiously is hand sanitizer. This is so weird, but like I needed to put it in because honestly I have been using this a lot. I also have another one over there that's a different brand, but at the end of the day I still use a lot of hand sanitizer, especially during this time in the world where everyone's just in panic and everyone's just scared of catching, you know, whatever is going on right now. I'm not gonna mention it because I don't want to get like demonetized or whatever, but yeah, it just reassures you that you're clean. I put this on so often. Like, even after washing my hands, I'll still put it on. Remember to wash your hands, guys. I've just been putting this on a lot, and honestly, I don't really like the smell of hand sanitizer. It just gets too strong, but you gotta do what you gotta do to stay sanitized and clean. So yeah, I've been using this a lot. And even if it dries out my hands, because I have really dry skin, I don't care. I'm still gonna stay sanitized. So yeah, stay sanitized and stay clean, guys. It's scary out there. The next thing is more of like an electronic thing that I got, but I didn't want to make it a separate category because it's like literally only like 1/2 things that are like the same. So yeah, the next miscellaneous item that I've been using a lot these days is this Logitech keyboard and also this mouse. I just got this recently, to be honest, and they actually sent this to me. They emailed me asking me if I wanted a keyboard and a mouse just to enhance my space, my desk space, and they look so cute and I really like the colors, so I said yes. And honestly, it's been so helpful. Even though I have a laptop that has a keyboard already, I've been trying my best to use this instead because I just love the color and I really want to use it. I feel like if you have an iPad, it would be really helpful to use this because then you could act as a laptop. Like, you can make your iPad into a laptop. This keyboard is actually Bluetooth, so it doesn't have any wires. It's just run by a battery, and it's just been so cute, and I really like the color of this. This is also like a matching mouse. This mouse has been the most helpful when it comes to my laptop because, especially when you're designing or doing things on your laptop and you're stuck with a trackpad, you can't always do very complicated things unless you're very talented. I don't know how to do that. I am very shaky. My hands don't really know how to do straight lines when I create art on my laptop. And especially now that I am actually studying a course that requires me to use programs like Photoshop or whatever, I feel like this would be really helpful. And honestly, it's been a lifesaver. So yeah, I've been really liking these 2 products from Logitech. And if you want to, you can check them out. I don't have a discount code. I'm sorry they just sent me the keyboard, but I will say I really recommend it. Like, it's really helpful. And it's cute too, so like, why not? Okay, the next category I want to talk about is apps. So I haven't really been using a lot of new apps these days. I've just been using, like, you know, the typical Instagram, YouTube. I use YouTube a lot. Like, I use that so often. That's like the first app I always open up when I go on my laptop and my phone. But lately I've been using a lot of TikTok. Actually, I've been using that for quite a while now, but I've been using a lot of TikTok. Maybe not so much these days because I've been like occupied with other other things like games, but for the most part, TikTok has been an app that I've been using more and more often compared to the usual apps that I've already been using. And I know a lot of people can relate with this. TikTok has just been taking over everyone's lives, especially nowadays that we're all stuck here. It's just a form of entertainment, and I'm not even complaining because all the things that on TikTok are so entertaining. People are so funny. As dry and cringy and cheesy as it is sometimes, like some videos on there are pretty cringe and cheesy, it's still entertaining and you just keep watching over and over again. Like there's something about TikTok that just makes people keep watching more and more. I don't know what it is, but I really enjoy it. I really enjoy the dances. Honestly, I'm determined to make that my source of like physical activity because I'm always stuck at home. I've always been stuck at home. Like regardless of this self-isolation thing, I've always been stuck at home. So that has caused me to like lack in my physical activity or exercise-wise. I just haven't been doing that. So I'm gonna try and implement TikTok dances into my everyday life just so I can get some form of exercise. They're actually harder than you think. So if you want to try exercising more, learn a TikTok dance because honestly, it's pretty hard to learn and it's also fun. So why not? Moving on to music. So I haven't really been listening to a lot of new music these days. Like I'm not always actively searching for music, and I think that's just based on like the type of person that I am. I literally have to be in a specific mood to be able to listen to new music, and that mood rarely comes. So I haven't really been listening to new songs. I haven't listened to any like new K-pop songs especially. The only times I would listen to the K-pop song is if I end up like watching a video with the song in the background or if someone's playing it in their Instagram story. That's pretty much the only time I'll ever like listen to a new song. And I'm being honest, I haven't listened to NCT's new album or their new song properly. I've had like a little glimpse at what it sounds like and I could already tell it's not really my style, so I just didn't continue really listening to it. Like it's good, but it's not really my type. I just haven't been delving into new music. So the only songs that I've been consuming over the past few weeks is mostly old school R&B, and I don't know if most of you guys will know some of these songs or just the songs that I listen to, but these are the songs that I've basically grown up with. Like I listen to these songs because my parents listen to them, and I've just been listening to them a lot because I don't know, it seems like I've been like yearning for this sense of like nostalgia, like the feeling of nostalgia. Like I kind of crave it. Just listening to these songs makes me so happy, and it just brings me back to the moments where I used to listen to it as a kid. It just brings back a lot of good memories, so that's why I've been listening to these types of songs. If you follow my Spotify, then you would see what I listen to, but I basically listen to my Take Me Back playlist and the songs that I've been really listening to. Like I've been playing this like non-stop. I've been listening to Keith Sweat's Twisted. I've been listening to Mariah Carey's songs, specifically Honey and also Heartbreaker, and also 112's Only You. I feel like a lot of my subscribers or followers are a bit younger and don't really know those songs, but either way, those are the songs that I've been consuming lately and I've just been really into it. But hopefully I can get out of it and kind of just explore more with music because my playlist has just been so dry. Like I've just been listening to the same songs over and over again and I feel like I need a change soon, but I don't know. We'll see in April. I don't know. We'll see. If you want to follow my Spotify link will be down below in the description. Like check it out. I want to share like music with you guys because I don't know, it seems like a fun thing to do now, taking advantage of what the internet has to offer. So next is YouTube channels. So I am constantly on YouTube. I mentioned this earlier. I always open up YouTube. If I go on my phone, I'll check YouTube and see who's uploaded a video or just see what's on my recommended page. On my laptop, it's the first thing I open up because I really just like watching videos and they just keep me company whenever I do different things. When I'm filling in my planner, when I'm just drawing, when I'm just not doing anything, I will just watch a video on the side and it's just so entertaining. The types of videos I like to watch most of the time is mostly vlog videos, chit chat videos, just anything relating to the YouTuber themselves. I really enjoy when people document their everyday lives. It's just so entertaining to me. It's so weird thinking about it. Like, you're watching someone live their life. Even if they're not really doing anything spontaneous, you're still watching them. It's kind of weird when you think about it. It's like kind of scary that like people are so entertained by that. But it's just so entertaining to see how one person lives, and you just kind of compare like, oh, that's how they spend their days. Well, I spend my days doing this. Like, you know what I mean? I just find that really entertaining, and I just like listening to people talk in general. That's why I don't really watch videos where there's not a lot of talking, because I like to multitask and I like to hear people talk while I'm doing whatever I need to do. And if there's no talking, I'm not aware of what they're doing, you know? So that's why I prefer talking over no talking. That's basically the basis of what type of YouTube channels I like to watch. But specifically, the YouTube channels that I've been watching these days, I've been watching PewDiePie and Fitz. PewDiePie is more like a random channel, like he does random stuff now. He used to do a lot of gaming stuff. I've been watching his PUBG videos that were like made 2 years ago, but they're really entertaining, so I really enjoy watching those gaming videos. That's why I also like watching Fitz, because Fitz is okay, it can kind of get a little offensive, like their videos, but just watching him play with his friends and them just having fun and making jokes while playing like Fortnite or Battlegrounds or just Counter-Strike, like it's just so fun. It's a really fun thing to be able to play with your friends, and I just really like watching Fitz because that's kind of what it's like when I play with my friends, you know? So yeah, I've been watching PewDiePie and Fitz, but for the most part, I've been watching a lot of vloggers and just other YouTubers. So I've been watching a lot of Jen Im. Before the start of 2020, or before maybe the end of 2019, I never really watched Jen Im. I don't know, I just never really got into her videos, or I just never really checked it out properly. But once I did, I watch her like all the time. I really enjoy her vlogs, just the way she presents herself. She's such an inspiration and just such a strong female role model. Like, I really appreciate the way that she is. She's just so positive and she seems so sweet and nice. It's just so inspiring and I just really love her. She has so much passion and motivation and she's just so talented, and I really aspire to be someone like Jen Im. But yeah, Jen Im has been one of my top most watched YouTube channels lately, and I honestly just thrive watching her videos. Next, I've been watching a lot of Best Dressed videos, so Ashley's videos. Best Dressed, Ashley is, she's like so iconic. She's amazing, and I'm pretty sure a lot of people know her. She does a lot of fashion videos. She just creates such beautiful videos. It's so well made. You can just see how hard she works on her videos, and like, again, I just really admire her for who she is, and I just love her grind and her passion to making film and YouTube videos. She's so pretty, she has such an amazing style, and she's just so entertaining to watch because she keeps it real as well. Like, she's not afraid to talk about real stuff. She talks about the struggles, she talks about what she goes through, and she just shows that YouTubers are just like us. We all go through our struggles, and we're just all doing our best to make sure that we make the most of living here on this world. She's just very entertaining to watch. So if you haven't watched Best Dress, I highly recommend that you guys check her out. I realized that the next two YouTube channels that I'm gonna talk about are also Ashley's, so I guess I have a thing for Ashley's. But yeah, anyway, the next YouTube channel that I've been watching is Ashley B. Choi. So she's actually a ex-member of Ladies Code, and yeah, she used to be a K-pop idol. I think now she just does radio stuff and also YouTube. I'm not entirely sure, but lately I've been like watching more and more of her videos because she's getting into YouTube, and she's vlogging her like moving process because she recently moved out of Ladies Code's dorm, and now she's living by herself and she's going through the stages of adulting. And she's just really entertaining to watch, and I've always looked up to her ever since I was younger. Ever since Ladies Code debuted, I've really looked up to them, especially with everything that happened. Like, I just really admire their strength to continue to do what they love to do. So I've always looked up to Ashley and I really love her for who she is. And I'm really glad that she's getting into YouTube because, I don't know, it's like this sense of connection with like a fan to their artist. Like you can see what it's like in their lives and you just connect more and see more of their personality and you just grow to love them more and more for who they are. And that's how I feel with Ashley. She's so sweet and I just hope that she's doing the best and I just love watching her videos. So she's also another YouTube channel that I've been watching lately. And lastly, the last YouTube channel that I've been watching is Your Mom Ashley. So this is another Ashley, but seems like I've been watching a lot of Ashleys. So Your Mom Ashley, I've been seeing a lot of her videos on my recommended. Like I see her videos recommended to me a lot, but I never really got to watch her videos. I don't know, I guess I'm just picky like that, but I never clicked on her videos. But one day I decided to watch one of her videos. I think it was like a college vlog, but she's such a cute and funny person. Like she's just so real. I love the way she acts and she's just so pretty as well. Honestly, all of the channels that I watch, they're just all so entertaining and I love watching them. And Your Mom Ashley just seems like the most genuine person. She has a very close relationship with her siblings, which I adore and love because, you know, family bonding is very important. I really appreciate when people have strong family relationships or whatever. I love my family and I love the fact that I'm close with my family and my cousins. So it's just really nice to see Ashley and her siblings get along really well with one another. So I'm pretty much a new viewer of Ashley, but so far I've been really liking her videos. She makes very cute content. She's vegan. She's very entertaining. And I aspire to be her, like just the way that she is personality-wise and just her face. She's just so cute. I love it. And that's why I love that Ashley as well. So yeah, those are the 4, 5, 6 channels that I've been watching these days. And yeah, that's pretty much it with YouTube channels. I'm pretty much almost done with this video. I'm just rambling on, but I'm almost done. And this next category is podcasts. So I've been slowly kind of getting into podcasts. Like I've been listening to podcasts for a while now, but I kind of stopped and I'm just getting into it again. So the podcast that I've been listening to these days is Timothy Delgado's No Chaser podcast and also a bit of David So's Genius Brain podcast. So the similarities between both of them is that these people, Timothy Delgado and David So, there's also Nikki Blades and Ricky Shocks, but overall, these people are very straightforward and real. Like, they literally talk about real stuff that happens in the world. They talk about, like, relationships and mental health and just the things that people sometimes sugarcoat and don't really talk about because they're kind of scared or they don't want to be judged. They don't care. They don't care if people judge them. They just say what they have to say, and it's just so real and authentic that it's enjoyable to listen to because you don't get a sugar-coated version of the topic. Like, they tell it like it's real. It's just nice to listen to these podcasts because it really gives you advice on like real life and just the way you should handle certain things. I mean, there's podcasts out there that are more, I guess, clean and pure, and they have more of like a well-presented approach to it, but it's also good to listen to podcasts that are like real and in your face because it like really just comes at you, you know what I mean? Like, I don't really know how to explain it. I'm pretty sure there's a lot of other podcasts out there that are good and nice to listen to, but just listening to the way David So or Timothy Delgado talks about situations and scenarios or topics, it's just entertaining. It opens your mind a little to different situations, and it really does feel refreshing to hear and listen to people talk about things without having to worry about getting judged or whatever. Like, they really don't give a crap about anything, you know? So yeah, they're very admirable, and those are just the podcasts that I've been listening to these days. If you know any other podcasts, let me know. And yeah, I've just been really liking it. And last but not least, of course, if you've been following me on this channel and also my Instagram especially, you would know that I've been really into games lately. And I made this the last category that I wanted to talk about because I felt like I had a lot of things to say about it, or just like I want to like really talk about it. Hopefully I don't talk too much because this video is gonna end up long, but overall I just love games these days. Like, these games have just taken over my life, and if I'm not journaling or planning in my planner, or if I'm not doing homework or assignments or whatever, I am on my Switch playing video games. So I've been playing games for all my life, to be honest. Like, I've always been into playing games, like on the computer with like the solitaire when that was a thing still. Those games like on Nickelodeon or Disney, or those Barbie games as well. I've always been into games. I also got into PlayStation games with The Last of Us. I've also played a bit of Call of Duty, I guess. I've played Guitar Hero. I played Wii. I've played the DS. Like, I've just always been into games, but it's never really like taken over my life completely. And these days it feels like I am kind of embodying the life of a gamer, because all I do is play games if I'm not doing anything else. Like, I could spend hours laying down playing games, and it's kind of concerning, but then again, I'm stuck in quarantine. What else am I supposed to do? So I'm just stuck playing games. Am I complaining? Hell no. So that's what I've been doing. And first, I'm going to be talking about the lovely game Fortnite, because that's basically the first game that I started to get into lately. Like, previously I got into Smash because I have Smash and that was the first game on my Switch, but I haven't been addicted to a game this much. Like, Fortnite really made an impact in my life. Fortnite just hits different. I feel like it's because of the hype for Fortnite. Like, you know, all the kids these days, they play Fortnite, they make Fortnite references, they do Fortnite dances. You just see Fortnite everywhere. Especially the previous years, Fortnite was a big thing. And I've always felt a bit intimidated by players who play Fortnite, because I knew for a fact that it's been a while now, the hype has continued to go on, and at this point, people are probably already so good at playing Fortnite that I could never reach that level. Oh, by the way, the whole premise of Fortnite is that it's a battle royale game. So what that means is a bunch of players get put into the game, and the whole point is to make sure that you are the last one standing in the game. If you're playing squads, then that means that your squad has to be the last one standing in the game, so you have to eliminate all the players. And that's basically how you win the game, and it's addicting because you just want to keep winning, and you just want to win at least once, especially if everyone else is good, and just one win will make you feel satisfied, you know? It is addicting, especially if you start getting into like the controls and you start learning how to aim right, you start learning how to build right. I was so bad back then, and after a while I started getting good, and I started like learning how to aim, I started learning how to like actually shoot people, and building, I'm still not that good at building, but like I'm getting there, and I'm determined to get better, and these people on Fortnite better watch themselves because I'm determined, you know? Yeah, that's basically me and Fortnite. Like, we're just this close right now. Okay, lately I haven't really been playing Fortnite as much as before because there's this other game that has taken over my life, and that is Animal Crossing. And that is like such like a contrasting game compared to Fortnite, because Animal Crossing is so relaxing and therapeutic to play. I guess it is. It can kind of get stressful, but it's not as intense as Fortnite. Fortnite, you're just playing intensely. You're trying to like eliminate everyone. In Animal Crossing, you're literally just chopping wood, catching fish, catching bugs. Like, it's not that competitive. So it's such a contrast with one another, but I think that's why I like it. Animal Crossing is like a break for me away from Fortnite. Not like I want to like move far away from Fortnite, but you know, there's days where I don't really feel like being competitive and intense. Animal Crossing fills that gap for me. I just feel so relaxed playing it. At times I get kind of like frustrated when I can't get my Nook Miles up, or just Iron Nuggets. Like, God, Iron Nuggets are so hard to find for me. But yeah, if you don't really know how Animal Crossing works, Animal Crossing is basically a game where you have your own character and it's all customizable. The whole premise is that you have your own island. Specifically for this new game, you have your own island. You basically do everything you can to live on that island. You build your house, you grab supplies from trees, you get food from trees, you catch fish, You sell your fish or animals or just any of your supplies to get money. You use that money to pay your home loan. It low-key teaches like adulting skills or just things that you need to know in real life because, you know, home loan is a thing and spending and saving money is a thing. And it's just a really great game because it's cute, it's fun, it's enjoyable, but it also kind of teaches you life skills. It also like teaches you to like recycle. It's just a really enjoyable and cute game to play. So if you want to check it out, I highly recommend you guys check it out. But yeah, those are the two games that have been taking over my life. And honestly, I have no regrets because they have brought me so much joy and they have kept me so sane during this time in the world. You know, I can't go out. None of us or those who are stuck at home, we can't go out because it's very risky to go out. So it's these things that have really like kept me sane and happy. Like, I'm not fussed that I have to stay at home because I'm occupied with like my little island and also just playing Fortnite and defeating all these other people. It's just really enjoyable, and honestly, as hard as it is right now, I think we'll all be able to get through it. And I just feel like there's always a way to find entertainment and there's always a way to be entertained. So yeah, that's pretty much the whole point of this video, just to show you guys that you can find entertainment and joy in the things around you. It doesn't necessarily have to be things that are in the outside world, you know what I mean? So yeah, that's basically my little ramble, and I think this video is really long and I've been talking a lot, but it's just been really fun to just talk and let out and kind of ramble on about the things that make me happy, because they really do make me happy. And I just hope you guys enjoyed watching this video regardless. I hope that you guys enjoyed this video, and if you did, please let me know if you'd like to see more videos like this, because I like to be able to just sit here and talk without having to worry about like getting my planner or my stationery items ready. Like, filming a vlog is a bit more time consuming because sometimes I want to like make it entertaining so I have to go out, but now I can't really do that. So I like being able to sit down here and just talk as if we're like sitting face to face, you know, having a chit chat, a girl chat, just talking about life and just all the random things that's going on right now. But yeah, I want to know what you guys have been up to lately and what has kept you company lately, and basically what your faves have been these days. Just let me know, because I want to talk to you guys, and for the most part I replied to most of your comments. So yeah, other than that, that's pretty much it for this video. I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and I hope you don't mind that I just sat here and rambled along about random stuff for like how many minutes. But yeah, I'll just pretty much talk to you guys in my next one. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you have a good day. Please stay safe and please take care of yourselves, and I'll just see you later. Bye!